Let's explore all the features and resources available in the Design Maker so that you can easily design your first Oliver Print product. I'll design a pair of yoga shorts to showcase how the Design Maker works and what you can do with it. Each design placement can be created separately to give you full creative control over your product. You can access each placement by clicking on the tabs up here. On the left is a toolbar where you can choose and upload design elements, text, color fill, and access product design layers. You can choose from many patterns and photos by browsing through Quick Design or Premium Image Collection. As an example, let's pick this black and white pattern. It automatically takes up the whole printing area, but you can change the scale, crop it, position it, and repeat this image in a pattern, just like I'm doing now. You can copy this design to other placements or design them individually. To copy a design, click Layers. Here, each design element is in a separate layer. If you want to copy your design to other placements, click Duplicate To and choose the option you want. If you have several layers, you can drag them to change which ones are closer to the front of the design. To fill the background of the whole garment with one click, you can also click Fill and choose a color, graphic, pattern, or premium image. It means that all of the print placements will have the same background. Now let's take a look at the clip art section. It has design elements sorted by different topics. Like with quick designs, you can transform, position, crop, and create a pattern out of a clip art of your choice. To check your product's appearance, click the mockup view icon. You can still return to the design view and switch things up by clicking the design view icon. If you want to create the design on another app such as Photoshop, create your design with a design template as a base. You can download templates from the product page by scrolling down, clicking on the File Guidelines tab, and then downloading templates for each placement to which you want to add your designs. Ensure your designs are saved in PNG or JPEG format with at least 150 dpi in the sRGB color profile. Once you've created your design, upload each file by clicking the Upload button. Before you start designing your first Oliver Print product, you should keep a few things in mind. These are the most common mistakes people make when designing an Oliver Print product: not covering the entire print area. You should create and upload designs that fully cover the entire print area. For example, if you upload artwork that doesn't reach the sides of the print area, all of this will just be bare fabric on the finished product. Putting graphics or text outside of the print area. For this example, let's say you're designing an Oliver Print t-shirt in available sizes and want this clip art to be visible on the t-shirt. The save print area matches the largest shirt size for the t-shirt model. For this shirt, it'll be 2XL. When someone orders a small size of your shirt, the size S shirt overlay is put on top of the actual print file. Everything that doesn't cover the small size overlay is cut off. If you put design elements outside of the print area, they may get cut off. It might be tempting to create designs that wrap around the entire garment. Our Oliver Print products are hand-sewn from multiple fabric panels, so even if a design looks good while you're putting it together in the Design Maker, we can't guarantee that the finished product will look the way you expected when it's fulfilled. That is all. I hope you'll enjoy designing your first Oliver Print product with Printful. Check out our YouTube channel if you want even more content on designing products, building an online business, and hearing tips and tricks from other sellers like yourself. Bye!